Hello, I'm Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado. And pardon the mess, but I've been doing a lot of projects on the side. And today, I thought it would be good to talk about something that I think that people get confused about. And that is, does persistence mean that you just stay with whatever you're doing and just keep on pushing? Not necessarily. Persistence means the attitude of continuing to accomplish whatever the goal is that you have in mind. And one thing I also know is that sometimes people start confusing a company or a product with their goals instead of realizing that that is their vehicle, that is their method of getting where they want to go, which means you can change that. And why I'm saying that is there are times when you have to come to a conclusion that the particular method or vehicle that you might have at this point might not be exactly right for you. For instance, I was involved with Empower Network. Of course, it's gone now. It's been gone for a couple of years now. I don't know exactly when it closed, somewhere around 2015-16. But anyway, or 17, you know, I don't care. It doesn't matter. I just wanted to tell the story that I got involved with Empower Network, and this was back in 2011, shortly after they had started. And at first, I really liked their vibe. I really liked what they were sharing. I really liked the kind of energy they were offering, and their products were simple and they worked. But there was a problem. They got greedy and wanted to keep pushing for more and more and more sales until it became unreasonable, and they kind of shamed you into buying them, because when you'd either get on one of their live streams or if you got on a live program, you know, actually went to the site and went to one of their events, they would actually go through kind of a trauma that I couldn't, you know, at the time I didn't realize what was happening, but it was kind of emotional beating, if you can understand what I'm talking about, kind of an emotional shaming, making you believe that you were somehow not quite adequate if you didn't buy all of the products. Now, obviously, it's a good idea to actually be a product of your product, which means that you generally will buy most of what is in your program. But it doesn't mean that you have to go into debt or kill yourself financially and actually do some harm to your finances to buy it. Now, I did do that. They had a $3,500 product, I guess it was, which I went into debt to get. Now, it doesn't mean that doing that is wrong. It's just that I did it because I was shamed into it, not because I felt a real need for that product or felt like it was going to help me in some way. And I think it's important to understand that whatever you're involved with, whether it's a digital product, a physical product, some kind of a service, it doesn't matter. You have to have a personal need for that product. You also have to have a belief that not only it'll help you, but it'll help others. And if you don't have either of those things, it is really hard to keep persisting through your business and to achieve a particular place where you want to go. For instance, I looked at all of the companies that at that time, and after I got to a point where I realized that I was being kind of pushed into doing that, even though it was not necessarily the right solution for me, and I didn't necessarily get a lot out of all of the products, I came to the conclusion that it was not for me. That didn't mean I left creating a business. It didn't mean that I left the online realm. A lot of people think that's what you do, throw out the baby with the bathwater. For me, I realized that it was important for me to continue building a business and working with people, but I had to be in the right place mentally as well as physically. And so when I left that program, I took a while to figure out that where I wanted to be. I like things that allows me to use tools and training to help other people. And I like coaching. I don't have to have a network marketing company, but I will do one if I find that I really appreciate their company philosophy and the way they do business. And in this instance, from here on, after that experience, I made that my underlying reason for saying yes or no. In other words, if they had a certain philosophy, like for instance, let me say, they believed in taking care of the customer or the prospect, realizing that that was the reason why they were in business. In other words, it's not the product, it's the person that you are helping that matters more. And I make that part of my own personal philosophy as well. So in order to be persistent and really truly stay in business for however long it takes until you receive what you want, you have to persist in something that has the values you want to see in your company. Because if you just persist because you are blindly in love with that company, that will not last. It's the same thing as being infatuated with somebody and not truly in love with somebody. You fall in love with something they do or something they say, but you don't really learn about who that person really is. And it's the same thing with a company that you might associate with. They have to have the values that match yours. For instance, do they pay their commissions not without fail, like it's their part of their mission statement to do that? The ones I'm involved with now do absolutely. And I'm not going to name names. It doesn't matter because I'm not trying to sell you a particular product or service. I'm telling you about what matters to me in my own philosophy. Are they absolutely honest to the point of almost fault? Yes, they have to be. Because I don't want to be in a position ever that I believe I have to compromise my own integrity for someone else or for a company. And so that's very important to me. So loyalty, integrity, the commission has to be stable and paid on time. I've been involved with a company where they stopped doing that. It wasn't the one I just mentioned, it was another. That is totally important. And then, of course, their products have to mean something to me. They have to have a worth. It's not just what they cost, it's what they value. I can value them to me. Because people don't buy something because of the cost or despite the cost. I know that you might think they do, but they actually don't. They have to decide that what you are sharing with them has enough value and benefit to them that they will find it of use to them and they will go buy it for their own reasons. No matter how hard you try to talk someone into it, you're not going to. They have to find a reason why it matters to them, why it is important to them, what they think they're going to get out of it. Because it really gets down to that. What's in it for me? That little phrase? They're always saying that in the back of their mind. So you need to answer that question. So part of your persistence is to learn enough about your company and product that you know what the benefits are. Not just what the ingredients are, because most people don't care. Or if it's a digital product, it doesn't matter what it does necessarily, unless it does something of value for that other person. And when it does, then it's of value to them. In a digital product, it could be a training. So what would that person learn that would benefit them from that product? Do you see what I'm saying? If you are not satisfying that personal need inside of that person, no amount of persistence will make your business work. So that's one of the things I know that is very important to me when it comes to my business. What is the value? What is it going to actually accomplish for someone else? What is it going to do for someone else? What kind of benefits are they going to get from it? When you become knowledgeable that way, you have a better chance of sharing it in the right way, because no amount of pushing makes a person stay in your business. But if they come to a point where they love it for their own reasons, then they don't have to be invited ever again to go buy it, because they'll do it for their own reasons. For instance, if I like to build pages, but it doesn't matter how much I like it. It has to be something that someone else does for their own reasons. So what is it going to do for them? Help them sell a product they're trying to promote. That's what's important to them. Do you see how I'm showing you what their benefits are from something that they do? If you're in a travel business, you first of all have to find customers that actually want to travel. You know, I'm at a point right now, at least, where I don't want to travel. And so it doesn't matter to me. That's probably a package arriving at my house. So I'm probably at a point where I don't want to travel. So a travel company would not be attracted to me, because there's no benefit for me personally. So you have to look at what that person really wants. And how do you do that? Ask questions. Don't be in a hurry to try to tell them about your business. Find out about them. Find out what their benefits are that they are looking for, what they want in their life, and what your business can do to make that happen. And then persistence is going to be simple as pie. I hope this has been helpful to you. If it has, please like, comment, and share. And also, if you would like to learn some good ways to market and build your business, let's have a conversation personally. And I'll be talking to you soon. Bye for now.